is everyone dressed like old-timey people? They are old-timey people. Wait, but that would mean... How old are you guys? Much older than any human. Does that mean you'll live forever? No, no, we don't age, but we can still get hurt and die.
Or can they? Sup, it's me, Gage, and today is, more of a Steven Universe talk. Now, Steven Universe is personally one of my favorite shows, just because I love the mortals and, frankly, the animation. Now, from what you saw from the very beginning, Pearl says that gems can get hurt and die. So she's basically talking about that if a gem breaks, they're dead. Well, I'm here to show you guys that that was either a lie, or she didn't know. Because Steven Universe has shown multiple times when gems have been broken, but stayed alive. They just can't summon a form, but they're still alive. Like when they meet the gem monsters that were forced fusions. Like right here.
For help, right? Yipe! What was that? Oh no! Gem
mutants! Now see, those are gems that were forced fusions. But as you can see, they're still alive, and they were broken. So just from seeing these guys, shows you that gems don't die upon being broken. Cracked just makes them act all weird, but multiple times the show has proven that once a gem breaks, their magic does not fade. Now, the only way I can see a gem actually dying is if their magic gets dispersed. But from what we've seen from the show so far, that hasn't ever been a case. Like, you can see the gems take them out. But, so yeah. Plus, they recently went to see the cluster, and Steven talked with it when it broke up. Or talked to them, and there were millions of gem shards. And Steven talked to them. Which shows only one real thing about this show. One, Pearl does not understand how gems live or die. And now, technically speaking, in a scientific term, since gems don't reproduce, they're not a living species. But then Rose Quartz had Steven, so that does make them a living species, technically speaking, because one reproduced. Now, this just shows that upon being broken, it's more of torture than death. The gems are still alive, they're just in great agony. Or at least lonely. Because in Nightmare Hospital, when they're walking around, the noises they make, if you play it backwards, they're asking Rose Quartz, Steven's mother, for help. So they're intelligent, they just can't say anything. So, apparently in the show, gems actually don't die from getting hurt. They just get really messed up. But, yeah, just thought I'd tell you guys that stuff. Because a lot of Rose Quartz's rebellion fighters got broken, and that's what Homeworld used for the fusion experiments. Now, they're all broken, all in shards, but they're all still alive. Asking for help. Which I thought was pretty cool, because it shows that the gems are more in torture than they are dead. Which means one day they all might be helped. But thought I'd just show that with you guys. So yeah, appears gems don't really die from getting hurt.